Hello dear students, in the previous episode of the chapter on applications of biotechnology, we have studied in detail application of biotechnology in medicine with special reference to production of genetically engineered insulin, gene therapy and various methods of molecular diagnosis. In the third part of this chapter, we will focus on the topics on transgenic animals and plants, including their significance to the society. We will also discuss some of the ethical issues in biotechnology. Dear students, first of all, let us see what are the transgenic animals. Those animals that have had their DNA manipulated to possess and express an extra or foreign gene are known as transgenic animals. Transgenic rats, rabbits, pigs, sheep, cows, and fish have been produced, although over 95% of all existing transgenic animals are mice. There would be certain questions in your mind that why are these animals being produced? How can man benefit from such modifications? Let us try to explore some of the common reasons. The first reason for their development is their ability to have normal physiology and development. Transgenic animals can be specifically designed to allow the study to how genes are regulated and how they affect the normal functions of the body and its development. For example, study of complex factors involved in growth, such as insulin-like growth factors. By introducing genes from other species that alter the formation of this factor and studying the biological effects that result due to this, the information is obtained about the biological role of the factor in the body. The second reason is their use in study of diseases. Many transgenic animals are designed to increase our understanding of how genes contribute to the development of disease. These are specially made to serve as models for human diseases so that investigation of new treatments for diseases is made possible. Today, transgenic models exist for many human diseases such as cancer, cystic fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis and Alzheimer's. The third significance of transgenic animals is that we can develop certain biological products by their use. Medicines required to treat certain human diseases can contain biological products, but such products are often expensive to make. Transgenic animals that produce useful biological products can be created by the introduction of the portion of DNA or genes which codes for a particular product such as human protein, alpha-1-antitrypsin, used to treat emphysema. Similar attempts are being made for treatment of phenylketonuria and cystic fibrosis. In 1997, the first transgenic cow, Rosie, produced human protein enriched milk. This milk contained 2.4 grams protein per liter. The milk contained the human alpha lactoalbumin and was nutritionally a more balanced product for human babies that natural cow milk produces. The next use of transgenic animals is in vaccine safety. As we all wish that before application on humans, every batch of vaccines should be tested for their safety. Transgenic mice are being developed for use in testing the safety of vaccines before they are used on humans. Transgenic mice are being used to test the safety of the polio vaccine. If successful and found to be reliable, they could replace the use of monkeys to test the safety of batches of the vaccine. One of the uses of transgenic animals is in chemical safety testing. This is known as toxicity safety testing. The procedure is the same as that used for testing toxicity of drugs. The transgenic animals are made that carry genes which make them more sensitive to toxic substances than non-transgenic animals. They are then exposed to the toxic substances and the effects are studied. Toxicity testing in such animals will allow us to obtain results in less time. Dear students, now let us see some of the accounts on transgenic plants. As we have discussed about them in the previous episode on applications of biotechnology in agriculture, here we will just briefly recall them. The transgenic plants have genes inserted into them that are derived from another species. The inserted genes can come from species within the same kingdom, which means plants to plant or between kingdoms, for example, bacteria to plant. In many cases, the inserted DNA has to be modified slightly in order to correctly and efficiently express in the host organism. Transgenic plants are used to express proteins like the cryotoxins from Bacillus thuringiensis, herbicide resistant genes, antibodies and antigens for vaccinations. Dear students, the manipulation of living organisms by the human race cannot go on any further without regulation. Some ethical standards are required to evaluate the morality of all human activities that might help or harm living organisms. Going beyond the morality of such issues, the biological significance of such things is also important. Genetic modification of organisms can have unpredictable results when such organisms are introduced into the ecosystem. Therefore, the Indian government has set up organizations such as GEAC, which is Genetic Engineering Approval Committee, which will make decisions regarding the validity of GM research and the safety of introducing GM organisms for public services. The modification and usage of living organisms for public services like food and medicine sources has also created problems with patents granted for them. Let us see what is biopatent. The right granted by a government to an inventor to prevent others from commercial use of his invention is called a patent. The patents granted for biological entities and processes are called biopatents. Biopatent is a controversial matter among different social groups due to the patenting of life forms. These objections are ethical or political. Most of the biotechnology patents are very broad in their coverage. For example, one patent covers all transgenic plants of Brassica family. So, financially powerful agencies can get monopoly control over biotechnological processes. Even agricultural research, including plant breeding, come under the control of such agencies. So, it will be a threat to global food security. The next issue in this line is biopiracy. Biopiracy is the term used to refer to the use of bioresources by multinational companies and other organizations without proper authorization from the countries and people concerned without compensatory payment. Most of the industrialized nations are rich financially but poor in biodiversity and traditional knowledge. In contrast, the developing and the underdeveloped world is rich in biodiversity and traditional knowledge related to bioresources. Traditional knowledge related to bioresources can be exploited to develop modern applications and can also be used to save time, effort, and expenditure during the commercialization. There has been growing realization of the injustice, inadequate compensation, and benefit sharing between developed and developing countries. Therefore, some nations are developing laws to prevent such unauthorized exploitation of their bioresources and traditional knowledge. The Indian Parliament has recently cleared the second amendment of the Indian Patent Bill that takes such issues into consideration, including patent terms, emergency provisions, and research and development initiatives. To sum up, I would say that bioethics is a set of standards that may be used to regulate our activities in relation to the biological world. Developments in biotechnology have raised several bioethical issues. Some of them are: use of animals in biotechnology cause great suffering to them. Transfer of genes from one species into another species violates the integrity of species. Transfer of human genes into animal and vice versa dilutes the concept of humanness. In some cases, it poses threat to environment and biodiversity. Each society has to evaluate the validity of these and other arguments related to biotechnology and also has to take appropriate decisions about them. So, students, Now, let us conclude this chapter on applications of biotechnology. Biotechnology has given to humans several useful products by using microbes, plants, animals, and their metabolic machinery. Recombinant DNA technology has made it possible to engineer microbes, plants, and animals such that they have novel capabilities. Genetically modified organisms have been created by using methods other than natural methods to transfer one or more genes from one organism to another, generally using techniques such as recombinant DNA technology. GM plants have been useful in increasing crop yields, reduce post-harvest losses, and make crops more tolerant of stresses. There are several GM crop plants which improve nutritional value of foods and reduce the reliance on chemical pesticides in order to produce pest-resistant crops. Recombinant DNA technological processes have made immense impact in the area of healthcare by enabling mass production of safe and more effective therapeutics. Since the recombinant therapeutics are identical to human proteins, they do not induce unwanted immunological responses and are free from risk of infection. Human insulin is made in bacteria, yet its structure is absolutely identical to that of the natural molecule. Transgenic animals are also used to understand how genes contribute to the development of a disease by serving as a models for human disease, such as cancer, cystic fibrosis, rheumatoid arthritis, and Alzheimer's. Gene therapy is the insertion of genes into an individual's cells and tissues to treat diseases, especially hereditary diseases. It does so by replacing a defective mutant allele with a functional one or gene targeting, which involves gene amplification. Viruses that attack their host and introduce their genetic material into the host cell as part of their replication cycle are used as vectors to transfer healthy genes or, more recently, portions of genes. We have also covered the current interest in the manipulation of microbes. Plants and animals has raised serious ethical questions like biopiracy, biopatent, and bioethics. With this, the unit on biotechnology is concluded. Students, let us make our world better with the positive values of biotechnology. Thank you.